psychometrician in the Student Wellness Center, IIT Bombay.
Hi, I'm Shaukat Ali, one of the counselors at Student Wellness Center, IIT Bombay.
There are many different myths surrounding mental health concerns, and they often contribute to the stigma that many people associate with mental health. In our experience, most of the stigma surrounding mental health is due to ignorance about the topic, denial of mental health concerns, or simply blaming the environment for psychological issues. Thus, as mental health professionals, it becomes very important that we challenge these widely held myths and throw light on the reality of mental health and well-being. We bring to you some of the most commonly held myths and the reality surrounding these misconceptions.
But the fact is, early intervention is very important in the case of mental health issues. Ignoring the early signs and symptoms may result in profound and long-term consequences. Being conscious about mental health problems at an early stage not only improves the probability of recovery but also increases the social, academic, occupational and personal functioning.
Fact is, one's ability to recognize that he or she needs help is a sign of maturity and self-awareness. It takes great courage to accept that one has issues and seek help. Mental health professionals are trained in the subject and are non-judgmental. Whatever is spoken in session is kept confidential. They listen to your issues and concerns from a solution-focused point. Thanks to the various mental health awareness programs, the new generation is getting better in their understanding of mental health.
Counseling is an active process which requires partnership between the client and the therapist. The goals of counseling or therapy are developed together between counselor and client. Often, it's not about fixing anything, rather helping the client to develop insight and learn necessary skills to resolve their own issues. Counseling is not an overnight solution. Depending on the nature and severity of the issue, the client will have to take more than one session with the therapist.
The fact is, professional counselors do not give advice, nor do they read your mind. They can help you understand your own self better. They help in getting insight into how you handle your situations and life in general. From this information, the client is given the strength and the tools to make his or her own decisions, which are healthy and productive.
But the fact is, having a mental illness does not mean you are crazy. It means you are vulnerable. It means you have an illness with challenging symptoms. The same as someone with an illness like diabetes. While mental illness might alter your thinking, destabilize your moods, or skew your perception of reality, that doesn't mean you are crazy. It means you are human and are susceptible to sickness and illness, the same as any other person. Anyone can meet a counselor or psychiatrist when they face any psychological problems, ranging from academic or career-related conflicts to severe mental health concerns. Counseling will bring you from confusion to clarity and facilitate decision-making.
Fact is that most people with mental illnesses are not violent, and only 3-5% of violent acts can be attributed to individuals living with a serious mental illness. In fact, people with severe mental illnesses are over 10 times more likely to have been the victims of violent crimes than the general population. You probably know someone with a mental health issue and don't even realize it, because many people with mental health concerns are highly active and productive members of our community. The reality is, depression is a very loosely used word. Without being professionally evaluated, it is best not to tag the label of depression to yourself or to others.
It can affect anyone based on their vulnerability, coping mechanisms, and social skills. Having unhealthy relationship can also add to the vulnerability. This can be addressed with the help of mental health professionals. Many leaders and celebrities are affected by mental health problems at some point in their life, the same as physical illness. Treatment for mental health problems varies depending on the individual and could include medication, therapy, or both. For some individuals with mental illness, medication is needed for survival. For others, like those who have mild to moderate symptoms of mental illness, medication can help ease symptoms so they can function normally. And having regular therapy combined with medication can greatly improve one's quality of life. Psychiatrists prescribe medicines based on the nature and severity of the illness. Mental health professionals are experts, empathetic, and very much mindful about the toll of treatment on you.
Our biggest takeaway from this Mythbuster video is, a stitch in time saves nine. We have to recognize that mental health is as important as physical health. Thus, it is our responsibility to ignore the myths and stigma surrounding mental health and seek the right professional help if need be.
We would like our students to know that IIT Bombay has a well-established student wellness center and strong support system to help students. Additionally, the alumni batch of 92 through its legacy project Bandhu has taken up the initiative to address a multitude of social, emotional, and mental health issues that students at IIT Bombay face. Especially in the challenging time of pandemic, addressing these issues have become even more essential.
In addition to these support structures, a self-help website is being developed with the aim to empower you, the students, with self-navigation skills to deal with key concerns in academics, mental health, relationships, and thus to help you to know yourself better.